Got a little more decimal arithmetic here for you. If you watched those last two decimals videos, you know what we're going to do here. Break out the place value. 32.4, that's 3 times 10 to the first, plus 2 times 10 to the 0, the 2's in the units place, and 4 is in the tenths place. 0.12, we have 1 in the tenths place, and 2 in the hundredths place. So we got everything written out in terms of their place value, and now what? Ah, this is a mess. What do we do with this? I mean, we could start breaking out the distributive property, but that'd even make it messier. Ah, this is no good. All right, it's time for one of my favorite problem-solving strategies, and that is do something else. The first thing you try on a problem isn't always going to work, and when you get on to really important, really challenging problems, the first thing you try almost never works. You have to be really good at moving on, trying something else. Try to find something that's going to help, because this isn't going to help us at all. So we'll get rid of that mess, and we'll try something else. What do we know how to do? This is a multiplication problem. So we have to think multiplication. What kind of multiplications do we know how to do? We know how to multiply integers. We know how to multiply powers of 10. We know how to turn decimals into integers times powers of 10. Ah, let's try that. 32.4, that's 324 times 10 to the minus 1. And we can check that. I like to check my intermediate steps and check that. 324 times 10 to the negative 1, multiply by 10 to the negative 1. It's the same thing as dividing by 10, which means moving the decimal point one place to the left, which is 32.4. So this is 32.4. 0.12, well, here we have to divide by 10 twice. So we have 12 times 10 to the negative 2. And again, we check it. 12 times 10 to the negative 2. Multiplying by 10 to the negative 2, it's the same as dividing by 10 squared. It's the same thing as dividing by 2 tens, and we get 0.12. So this product of decimals is this product of integers and powers of 10. We're multiplying four things here. We can multiply them in whatever order we want to, and what we want to do is multiply the integers and multiply the powers of 10. We'll take care of the integers first. We'll use a little distributive property, 324 times 12. That's 324 times 10, which is 3240, plus 324 times 2, which is 648. Then we add those up, and we get 3,888. So we've taken care of the integers. Now the powers of 10, the bases are the same. We add the exponents, and that gives us 10 to the minus 3. And we know how to deal with an integer times a power of 10. We can write this as a decimal. Multiplying by 10 to the negative third is the same as dividing by 10 cubed. It's the same as dividing by 10 three times. Move the decimal point 3 places to the left. We get 3.888. And we can do a quick sanity check to make sure our answer at least has the decimal point in the right place by thinking about quick estimation for this calculation. 32.4, that's around 30. 0.12, that's around a tenth. 30 times a tenth, 30 divided by 10 is 3. This is around 3. So that gives us some more confidence that we're correct here. I like to do these quick checks, make sure I didn't make any mistakes that would be easy to catch. Now that we know how to deal with multiplication, let's move on to division. Now that multiplication problem, we tackled that by turning it into a problem about integers. Let's try the same thing here, because we sure don't want to write out place values for this. I mean, it's hard enough to divide by something easy. Dividing by something messy is, But here, we'll try to take the something messy and turn it into something we know how to divide by. We'll start off, I like to think of divisions as fractions, because I know lots of things I can do with fractions. Now, I don't like to divide by a decimal. So what I want to do is turn this into a fraction with the denominator is an integer. So I'm dividing by an integer instead of by a decimal. And I know how to turn fractions into other equivalent fractions, I strategically multiply by 1. This is just like we did when we were adding fractions or comparing fractions. Here, we're trying to divide by a decimal. Instead, I want to divide by an integer. I'm going to multiply the numerator and the denominator by 10 cubed. I'm just multiplying by 1 here, so I'm not changing the value, but this makes the denominator an integer because we move the decimal point 3 places to the right, and we get 14. And up here in the numerator, again, we move the decimal point 3 places to the right. Got to remember these zeros. These zeros are very important. because I've moved the decimal point 3 places out to the right. And now I have a problem that's about integers. Took a messy problem about decimals, turn it into a problem about integers. This fraction is the same as this fraction. This is a problem we know how to handle. Go ahead and knock off this division. 53,200. Divide 14 into 53. 14 goes into 53, it's 3 times. Leaves us 11 left over. And let's see, 14 into 112. Well, 14 times 4 is 56. Double that is 112, so this must be 14 times 8. And again, we need to remember these zeros out here. And we can, again, use a quick estimation to see that we're at least close to the right answer here. 53.2, that's around 50. 0.014, that's around 1/100. So this is going to be somewhere close to 50 divided by 1/100. If you divide by 1/100, that's the same thing as multiplying by 100. 50 times 100 is around 5,000. Well, that is 5,000. So we expect our answer to be around 5,000. This is around 5,000, so we're at least sure that we didn't get the decimal point off by 1, that the answer shouldn't be 380, it shouldn't be 38,000. We're pretty confident our 3,800 is correct. We have the right answer. Now let's do a quick recap what we've done on these problems. Multiplication of decimals. We turned it into multiplication of integers and powers of 10. Over here with division, took division of decimals and turned it into a problem about division of integers. Two examples of a very, very powerful strategy. You take something you don't know how to do and you turn it into something you do know how to do. We'll be right back.